Well, hello. Thank you for the opportunity to speak with you today about human resources and giving a department, a human resources department update. Specifically, what I'm going to be talking about today is with regard to our certificated staff, change over time and what recruiting looks like, because we're right now in the thick of the hiring season. So with that, we'll jump right in. For those of you who have been a part of Liberty Public Schools for a long time, this data is probably no surprise to you. I started my career 3 decades ago, and Liberty Public Schools certificated staff, our classroom teacher numbers were in the 200s, and today we're almost to 1,000 students in the district. So Liberty Public Schools as a community and as a school system has changed significantly over the years. But what really is remarkable and what I wanna draw our attention to is kind of what the growth of Liberty schools have looked like, its impact on classroom teachers, and what we're likely going to be seeing as we move forward. So our student enrollment, if we look back just over the past decade, you see that students kindergarten through grade 12, and the average enrollment for each of those classes is above 916. Now this data is a year old. We pulled this from the DESE website. So the seniors here have graduated. They're freshmen in high school now. And so the 11th grade number, our first class of 1,000 students, are seniors right now. They'll be graduating in the class of 2021. And you'll see that that class of 1,000 was consistent for a handful of years. A new kindergarten class coming in had 1,000 plus students in it, and that existed for 6 years of that. And then our enrollment started to taper down below 1,000, and you see each class that's been coming in behind the previous class is down. So that 1,000 student class that accounted for this sizable jump in our FTE right here in 08 and 09 are seniors now. And as they graduate, that swelling of enrollment is going to start declining with it. In fact, if we look at what the percent of change over previous years in enrollment, you'll see what I mean. So if 2011 is our baseline year, 2012 saw almost a 4% growth over the previous year. And since that time, the percent growth over the previous year, we've still been growing as a district, but that percent growth has declined pretty steadily since that time. And the class of 2020's change, this is the 1920 school year, saw a 0.53% growth over the previous year. Obviously, we don't have the 2021 school year growth data because that still is in flux this year. But that steady decline we anticipate continuing for us as a district. And that will likely translate into less and less of a demand for teachers in the classroom as the student enrollment population decreases a little bit. And I say decrease really using that loosely. We're still growing as a district. We're not growing as significantly or as rapidly as we have in the past. Now, it's good news that if our enrollment is starting to taper out a little bit as we move forward, that our demand for teachers may be less in the coming years. And that is good news because the supply of teachers is actually diminishing as well. These are nationwide statistics, but high school graduates are surveyed every year as to what they plan to do when they graduate high school. And the percent of graduating seniors nationally who express an interest in becoming an educator has been steadily declining. In the 70s, you know, it peaked at 13.2%. When I started in this profession, graduating seniors were looking at about 11% expressing interest in being a teacher, and that's dwindled to where it's now below 5%. And that decline is seemingly pretty steady. So interest in coming into our profession has waned. That, of course, is translating to a diminishing teacher pipeline. And it is, even though these are national trends, it is impacting us here locally in Liberty Public Schools. So this is our new hire induction class trend for Liberty Public Schools specifically. And you see, if we go back to when I started here in Liberty Public Schools, about 60% of the new hire induction class were folks coming right out of college entering the profession. And now it's about a third. So from almost two-thirds to a third, that's a pretty significant change in terms of the percent or slice of that new hire induction class who are coming to join our team with no teaching experience. Now, that's good news for kids. It means more and more we're seeing veteran staff come into the system to teach students. But if we were to project out far enough into the future, the veteran staff that you're relying on to fill your vacated positions eventually will age up and age out and retire. And without high school students graduating, going into college and choosing education as a profession, we're going to find it more and more difficult to find talent. For school systems like Liberty, that's still decades away in terms of becoming a real issue for us. For some school systems that see very large turnover year over year, a third of their teaching staff turning over, that problem is going to be confronting those school systems much quicker. We see about 6.5 to 7% turnover year over year, so it's not likely to impact us as much. But we don't want to wait until it does impact us to do something about it, and so our recruiting strategy really is to focus on grow your own. This is a statewide initiative. We've been a part of the statewide initiative for quite some time. And the Grow Your Own initiative really is designed to cultivate within our own ranks people who may have a passion for moving into education as a profession. And then what can we do to incentivize that so that we affect our teacher pipeline, not just here, but in all districts. The idea being that if every school system is focused on Grow Your Own teacher programs, then the profession as a whole benefits. So in Liberty Public Schools, our Grow Your Own teacher program looks like this. We've had an educator internship program for quite some time, but kind of elevating and spotlighting and marketing that program differently to kids as they move up toward their senior year is a big part of growing that internship program. Partnering with colleges and universities, maybe to couple some of that with some college credit, dual credit opportunity for students who participate, so that when they go to college and major in education, they'll always already have a leg up on some of those college credits. So that's a part of that EIP expansion. We also started a few years back a Grow Your Own Teacher Loan Forgiveness program specifically for students of color. The teacher pipeline is dwindling across the board, but it's significantly a small, significant pipeline depletion with regard to applicants of color, candidates of color, people wanting to come into our profession and teach kids. So we are incentivizing through a loan forgiveness program our Liberty Public Schools students of color who are interested in being educators, so that hopefully we can incentivize that work and matriculation through college, make it more affordable for students. And then if they come back and teach for us for a period of time, then the investment that we've made in their education is forgiven over time. So it's a win-win for the student going off to college, and it's a win for Liberty Public Schools in terms of diversifying our workforce. We also have started a Grow Your Own Teacher program for our classified staff. This is in partnership with Teach Kansas City. And this is designed to identify support employees like paraprofessionals or custodians or administrative assistants who came into this profession and have discovered they really have a passion for it and want to turn the corner and become a classroom teacher. How can we partner with them and with colleges and universities to help make that happen without them having to quit their job and go to school full time? And so that partnership is being launched right now. We just sent out a survey to better understand what the interest level is among our classified staff, and then we'll be working with them and with the Teach Kansas City program to start turning the corner on career goals for those interested individuals. And then, of course, a big part of our Grow Your Own Teacher program involves you as an ambassador for the profession. Every time you identify in students qualities that would make them an exceptional future teacher and have a conversation with them about these qualities that you see in them and fan the flames of interest in education, you add one more person to that teacher pipeline in the future. So those are ways that we are investing in our own students right now currently to affect the teacher pipeline and hopefully stave off that day when the demand for teachers exceeds significantly the available supply for those hires. And then outside of just our own students, we're in partnerships with colleges and universities, again with Teach Kansas City, to have monthly roundtables, regular roundtables with colleges and universities about how we can affect what the curriculum is that these colleges and universities are teaching, and then affect the readiness of those graduates when they step into the classroom here in Liberty Public Schools. And then, of course, completely flipping on campus recruiting and what that looks like. Going and visiting college campuses and standing in a fair environment with students who are about to graduate really is not paying the kind of dividends that it has in the past. And But COVID has brought on virtual experiences that we are seeing really be quite profitable for us. So that's another thing that we're doing to affect the recruiting of teachers, classroom teachers for Liberty Public Schools. So thank you for the opportunity to give you just a few highlights. And as a Human Resources Department, of course, we are here to serve you. We're always available. Feel free to email us or call here at the Administration Center, and we will assist you. Thanks so much.